Imagine sending a postcard across the globe where anyone along the journey can read it. That's how your data is without encryption. Encryption is like a sealed envelope for your postcard. It stops any onlookers from reading your messages and only allows the intended recipient to unseal the envelope. Encryption is an essential part of how critical parts of our society function. Transactions and purchases use encryption so that your money is secured, and the majority of connections on the modern internet use encryption to secure everyone's data. So encryption keeps your data secure online. But how does it work? Encryption most commonly takes on two forms. Symmetric encryption, where each party holds the exact same key, and asymmetric encryption, which is also known as public key cryptography. With asymmetric encryption, each person has a public key they share with others that lets them receive encrypted messages, and a private key they keep to themselves that lets them decrypt the messages they receive. Symmetric encryption is extremely fast and secure, but it presents a challenge. If you want to talk to someone you've never talked to before, how do you both get the same key in advance? Asymmetric encryption is much slower and more complex, but it solves this problem. Now you can publish your public keys for anyone to see, and they can use your public key to send you a message that can only be decrypted with your own private key. Whenever you browse the internet every day, your browsing is secured using encryption. This is called HTTPS. HTTPS uses a protocol called TLS, or Transport Layer Security. Almost 90% of websites on the web use HTTPS to secure the connection between you and the website. TLS uses both asymmetric and symmetric encryption to protect your data. When you connect to a website with HTTPS, the server sends you their public key in the form of an HTTPS certificate. You can then use that certificate to send a message to the website that only the website can decrypt. Now here's the trick. If you were to only use this asymmetric encryption, you would have to send the server a public key of your own for them to send you an encrypted message in return. What if instead of simply sending the website the encrypted message you wanted to give them, you send the website a brand new symmetric encryption key that is encrypted with their public key from before? This shared symmetric encryption key can secure all future messages. This is called a key exchange, and it's a method of using slower and complex asymmetric encryption to securely exchange a symmetric encryption key between two parties that have never talked to each other before. In HTTPS, this symmetric key you've shared is stored for the duration of your visit. Then it's discarded. If you visit that website again in the future, you'll perform a brand new key exchange with new symmetric keys each time. Encryption is integrated into many different areas of our lives. For example, your mobile phone storage is secured using encryption. This is called file-based encryption. The files on your device are encrypted using the password of your device. Without the passcode to the device, all your data will be inaccessible. Secure messaging apps utilize encryption discreetly to secure your message content and information about your messaging activity from attackers and bad actors. This means that only you and the recipient can read the messages you send. Without encryption, the service you're messaging on could read your messages. Two-factor authentication apps utilize an encryption algorithm called TOTP, or time-based one-time password, which generates codes on a repeating basis using a cryptographic hash and a shared secret key that both the user and the website hold. This is highly secure because the six-digit code is generated based on a cryptographic hash. So only somebody with the cryptographic hash can generate that specific code. We live in a world where almost everything is connected to the internet. Our private messages, emails, and social interactions are typically stored on a server, somewhere. The obvious problem with this is that the service provider, or a hacker who has compromised the server, can access your communications, whenever and however they want, without you ever knowing. Thankfully, end-to-end encryption can alleviate this issue by encrypting communications between you and your desired recipients before they are even sent to the server. The confidentiality of your messages is guaranteed, assuming the service provider doesn't have access to the private keys of either party. It's important to note that while communications are encrypted end-to-end, if either end is compromised, then the data is unencrypted. Or as in a recent example, if you accidentally add someone to your encrypted group chat, the encryption won't be protecting your conversations. Recently, the UK government forced Apple to drop support for advanced data protection for its UK users. This feature increased the security of iCloud by enabling end-to-end encryption for additional categories, like files, backups, and photos. This is a worrying precedent to set. Disabling or not allowing people to use encryption because of a government request could lead to further services being restricted or banned. The mathematical nature of encryption makes it impossible to backdoor or break the encryption only for the good guys. Inserting such a compromise would allow hackers and bad actors to also access the encrypted data. It's essential to push back against governments trying to ban encryption, as it threatens the freedom and privacy of everyone. For people in vulnerable positions, encryption can be the difference between life and death. Just because you don't need encryption for everything you do, doesn't mean that the fundamental right to use it should be denied. Thanks for watching. Get subscribed so you don't miss out on any future videos. We wouldn't be able to produce these educational and informative videos without our members and donors. So if you got value from this video, consider making a donation. See you next time on Privacy Guides.